How about a nice hand for Brian Sand and his quintet? The graduating students will be coming into the tent in about 1 minute. It would be a very nice gesture, I think, to give them a round of applause. You don't need to applaud while they're seated because that takes probably 10 minutes. But a minute or so of applause would be very nice, and you'll hear them coming in on the right side of the tent, and we'll be back for a few comments a little later. Nice hand for our piper, please. My name is David Harp. I'm University Marshal, and my first task today is to introduce Jocelyn Yunan, who is the Associate Registrar, who has a few remarks with respect to the possibility, which is highly unlikely today, it's a perfect day, as you can see, of a tent evacuation, so we need to do this. Jocelyn.
Bonjour. Your safety is our priority. If an evacuation is required, the registrar will announce this to you. You will then be required to leave the tent immediately. Depending on the circumstances, you will be evacuated to another building or to the field across the tent. Leave all baby strollers behind, but take the babies with you. Do not go with the graduating students. They will be evacuated to another location. If you're evacuated to another building, graduates, go to the arts building. Guests, follow the colored lines on the roadway that correspond to the chair you're sitting on. So red goes to Redpath Hall, black goes to Leacock Building, and white goes to the University Center. We will be making announcements there as to the continuation of the ceremony. At all times, if you need assistance or help, the medic is on site. Please speak with an usher or a security officer. Have a wonderful day. Congratulations again. Maintenant en français. Si vous devez évacuer, la registraire en fera l'annonce. Il y a deux façons d'évacuer. Soit vous allez au terrain qui est juste en face de la tente, ou sinon dans un édifice. Les édifices seront marqués par rouge pour les chaises rouges. Vous allez au Redpath Hall. Les chaises noires iront au pavillon Leacock. Et les chaises blanches iront au centre universitaire. Les gradués iront au Arts Building. Si vous avez besoin d'assistance ou d'aide d'un professionnel de la santé, veuillez vous adresser à un agent de sécurité ou un placier. Je vous remercie beaucoup de votre attention. Vous avez vraiment fait attention à mes instructions. Alors, passez une journée inoubliable et félicitations aux diplômés. Merci beaucoup.
Very shortly, the platform party will be coming down the main road at McGill, and I'm trying to hear the piper, but I don't. I appreciate your quasi-organizational capacities this morning to the graduates. There were gaps as wide as a football field between some groups, and we thought it was finished, and then you came. So I hope in your business dealings, you'll be just maybe that much more organized. You can blame your professors. So one thing I would say is that the very first person to the stage is maybe, should be, could be the most nervous. Everybody else, follow what the person in front of you does. There's markings on the floor adjacent to the first dais, the one opposite on your left, opposite on my side to your left. And you have your lineup card. Be sure that you don't leave it at your desk or in a pocket that you can't access or forget about, because you will need both parts of that lineup card. The first is to give your name and your degree, etc., to the reader who will do the job of reading, and then you walk across the stage, and then you're capped or tapped by either the chair of the board, the chancellor, or Principal Fortier. Then you will proceed across, and I will say the very first step of this downward five-step stairs is extra long, so don't be aware of it, because quite easily you could fall. We have a fall catcher ready to grab you, but it won't be fun. And if you're wearing high heels, ladies, I'm assuming. Be very careful going up the stairs because you can catch, and don't hurry too fast across the stage. There's plenty of time. Your day in the sun or your day on the television, as it were, or the broadcast that we're doing around the world will be about 15 seconds in total. So enjoy it. You can wave. Try not to say anything that's too loud, other than your colleagues will be going, woo-hoo, regularly. And in fact, at the medicine ceremony yesterday, there were 650, roughly, who graduated, and every one of the MD graduates got almost a standing ovation, which was a little hard to hear names. It worked out. It was just fine. The chancellor organizes the entire ceremony with help, obviously, and has the lines to speak properly. And he will occupy the center throne, as it is, right in the middle of the stage, and he will come back and forth to the dais. We'll start the ceremony with the singing of the Alma Mater by Winston Purdy from the music faculty, and conclude the ceremony with our national anthem at the end. You can hear the piper coming in now, and I would ask that when they come into the tent that you rise for respect for that platform party. The last group in the platform party will be the principal, chair of the board, and chancellor. Levez-vous, s'il vous plaît. Please rise for the platform party.
Morning.
Thank you, Professor Purdy. Good morning, graduating students, families, friends, ladies and gentlemen. Bonjour à tous. As Chancellor, on behalf of McGill University, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the 2016 convocation ceremony for students graduating from the Desautels Faculty of Management. I extend a warm welcome. I extend a warm welcome to all of you, parents, friends, and partners of today's guests of honor, our graduates. And indeed, I particularly welcome you, you who are about to become McGill's most recent alumni. Your attendance here, I know, means a lot to your family. Two of our sons are McGill graduates, and I've had the chance to sit in the audience watching the proceedings the way you are about to today. Lorsque j'ai assisté à la collation des grades en tant qu'invité, les fonctions du chancelier étaient accomplies par un homme merveilleux nommé Arnold Steinberg, un ami généreux et fidèle de McGill, qui malheureusement est décédé décembre dernier. Arnold relished these convocation ceremonies, along with every part of his long history with the university. And as the principal said in her eulogy, he fully embodied the McGill spirit, a spirit that unites curiosity, intellectual rigor, energy, and compassion. And while he graduated in 1954 and led a rich life outside our gates, in a very real sense, he never left McGill. Today you can appropriately reflect on the curiosity, intellect, and energy that got you to McGill in the first place, and that has made you successful while you have been here. Along the way, you've been exposed to superb teachers and researchers, and you've had the chance to engage in critical thinking with others and to reflect on your views about our world and your place in it. This, I hope you will agree, was a wonderful opportunity, made even more special because it happened here at McGill. À titre d'anciens étudiants et diplômés, il vous deviendra bientôt évident que McGill jouit d'une réputation unique. Dans ce monde de plus en plus concurrentiel et international, dans lequel vous êtes sur le point d'entrer, McGill suscite un respect et une admiration remarquables, particulièrement à l'échelle internationale. Now, regardless of what your next step is, I hope that you look on your years here as being happy, productive, and rewarding. Of one thing I am confident, and that is that few investments you will make will provide as much of a financial return and as much of personal satisfaction. And when you do think about McGill, I'd ask you to remember that most every experience that you've had that was core to McGill's mandate has been enhanced and shaped by those who came before you. I speak particularly about those graduates who have supported this university financially and with the gift of their time. Again, I think of Arnold Steinberg, who for many years was so very generous in so many ways to his alma mater. I read recently an article written by a Canadian expat, Hardeep Grewal. It was titled, "Universities Help Us to Achieve. Let's Pay It Back, Canada." His point was that, for some unknown reason, Canadians are quite adept at resisting any kind of sectarian affinity for the institution where they got their education. He thought it was, and again I quote, "high time for Canadians to stop just liking their university and to start loving them." He suggested that rather than being just a rite of passage, graduates should see their graduation as inauguration into a very special community. So today I ask you to start loving your university, or perhaps I should say to keep loving McGill. Votre attachement continu fera en sorte que notre université maintienne sa réputation enviable en tant que l'un des principaux établissements d'enseignement supérieur au monde. To each of you here this morning, who will shortly take your place among the some 250,000 graduates of McGill scattered around the globe in over 180 countries. My sincere congratulations for your achievement, and I wish you every success as you embark upon the next phase of your lives. Thank you. Merci. Je voudrais maintenant inviter la professeure Suzanne Fortier, principale et vice-chancelière de l'Université McGill, à s'adresser à l'auditoire. Madame Fortier.
Bienvenue aux finissants de 2016. Welcome to the Desotel Faculty of Management graduating class of 2016. I'm joined here today by your family and friends, by our chancellor, the chair of our board, our governors, governors emeriti, and our chancellor emerita, by our distinguished honorary degree recipient, award recipients, by special guests, esteemed colleagues. We are here together to say how proud we are of you and of everything that has brought you here today. C'est pour moi un immense bonheur de vous féliciter pour vos réalisations et votre résilience. It is a great honor to congratulate you on your achievements and your perseverance. Today marks an important milestone. Savor it, enjoy it, celebrate, and remember the moment. As you may know, my own degrees from McGill are in crystallography. That means that I like numbers, big data. I know you're numbers people too, so allow me to share a few numbers with you. And since we are in Montreal, I'll start with the number 40,000. That's the number of bagels that were eaten in our residence last year by our students. And of course, they come from the Mile End. And speaking of food, we had 25,000 kilograms of fresh produce grown on our own McDonald's campus that was eaten on our campuses at McGill. And we're talking, yes. So 25,000 kilograms of apples, cantaloupes, tomatoes, kale, isn't that fantastic? Now, a bigger number, 5,531,792. This is the estimated number of Canadians of working age that have a degree, a university degree. And that represents 28% of the Canadian population at working age with a university degree. When you compare that with the OECD average, we're doing well. The OECD average is 23%. And it's a number to remember because you don't arrive at this number just by chance. It is a real commitment of our country to ensure that education is available to everyone. Two more numbers, 19 and 68. The youngest and the oldest graduate, and the diversity of our students is what really make our campus and our environment here at McGill so special and so rich. 7,337 of you will be graduating this spring, and I'm thrilled that 2/3 of our students will be able to come to convocation, and some traveling from far away. And I know from your enthusiasm this morning that this is a great moment. It's a great moment to celebrate. But convocation is something else. It is a demonstration also of loyalty. Loyalty to your classmates. Loyalty to the family and friends who've helped you get here today. Loyalty to your professors, librarians, staff, all the people who have been there, rooting for you from day one. And so today, because this is a special day for them, I want all graduates to please stand up, all of you who are graduating, please stand up, and you're going to give a big round of applause to the people who've been rooting for you. Thank you. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. I'll end with one number, one that I really like very much, and that is number one. I like this number very much, not only because, well, not really because it's great sometimes to be able to call yourself number one, but that's not really why I like the number. Think about this. There are 7.4 billion and counting of people on this planet, but there is only one of you. And that's why I like that number. There's only one of you. What that means is not that you're number one in terms of competing with your colleagues, but what we're talking about here is about you. The unique you, making the best of what is unique about you. And that really is the challenge that is ahead of you in the next chapter of your life, and in fact, for the rest of your lives. What is unique about you, and what will be your own contribution, your unique contributions to the world? We are very fortunate to have some excellent role models with us today. As you know, in the convocation ceremony, we will bestow an honorary doctorate upon Mr. Larry Rossi, whose own talents, his own unique talents, have helped him grow his family's business into a retail empire, and then to give back to the community through transformative, philanthropic vision and generosity. Convocation marks a beginning, but it's also time to say goodbye. This is Stephen Strawpoll's last spring as McGill's Secretary General and one of his final convocation ceremonies. Over the past 6.5 years, he has proudly watched over 60,000 students graduating from McGill. As Secretary General, Stephen has provided wise counsel and sound judgment. He has worked hard to help strengthen the policies that reflect the McGill community's shared values, and importantly, to put these policies into practice. Thank you, Stephen, for your quiet determination and your steadfast commitment to the stewardship of good governance. Merci beaucoup, Stephen. And to all the graduates, after you've said your own goodbyes, remember the friends you've made during your time here at McGill and keep them close. À nos diplômés, sachez que vous vous joignez à une belle et grande famille. En fait, vous savez, j'ai reçu un message d'un membre de la famille. You got a tweet from one member of our family. I don't know if you saw it. Monsieur Justin Trudeau tweeted our McGill grads, and his message is, you are not the leaders of tomorrow. You are leaders today. Congrats, McGill graduates. Sachez que les portes de McGill vous seront toujours très grandes ouvertes. McGill will always be your home. Félicitations, congratulations.
Thank you, Professor Fortier. I now ask Professor Isabelle Bajeux, Dean of the Des Hôtels Faculty of Management, to introduce this year's winners of the Teaching Awards. Professor Bajeux.
Thank you very much, Madam Vice Chancellor, Mr. Chancellor. It is with great pleasure that I present to you Professor Sébastien Béternier. Winner of the Distinguished Teaching Award for undergraduate programs at Desautels. Professor Béternier has been teaching and researching in the areas of finance and investment at the faculty since 2010. According to his students, his enthusiasm for these subjects is contagious, thereby fostering an environment of genuine interest within his classes. He has a talent for connecting complex financial topics to real-world examples, and often supports the course materials with industry research and news. Indeed, some of his students commented that his teaching has encouraged them to pursue higher studies related to finance. Outside of the classroom, he is committed to helping his students succeed, making time to listen and offer feedback, and even coach them for case competitions. Professor Béternier's dedication to our students and his contributions as a teacher are exemplary. He's certainly most deserving of this honor. Madam Vice Chancellor, I present Professor Sébastien Béternier. Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you. Professor Sujata Madan, winner of the Distinguished Teaching Award for graduate programs at Desautels. A four-time recipient of this award, Professor Madan joined the faculty in 1994 and teaches finance and economics at the undergraduate and graduate levels. She currently serves as the academic director of the MBA program. She has been described by her students as passionate about what she teaches and committed to their learning. To quote one student, "I have never come across a teacher as knowledgeable, dedicated, and stimulating as Professor Madan." She's widely acknowledged for being skillful at engaging her students by using a creative and personalized approach to teaching complex financial concepts. Outside of teaching, she is renowned for her personal commitment to act as a mentor to all of our students and to ensure they become the best versions of themselves. Professor Madan's contributions as a teacher and mentor to our students are exemplary, and she's certainly most deserving of this honor. Madam Vice Chancellor, I present Professor Sujata Madan.
Thank you, Professor Bajou. I now ask Professor Isabelle, I now invite Principal Fortier to present Mr. Lawrence Rossi, that he may have conferred upon him the highest recognition that it is within the power of this university to confer. Professor Fortier.
Today, we celebrate the vision and generosity of a man who is deeply committed to improving the wellness in body and mind of his fellow Quebecois and Canadians. Lawrence Rossi is known as a business leader, and for good reason. In 1910, Larry's grandfather, Salim Rossi, opened a single store near the Old Port. Larry's father, George, then built that store into a chain of 20. In 1973, 8 years after completing his BA at McGill, Larry took leadership of his family's successful retail business. Over the next two decades, he grew the Rossi chain, more than doubling the number of locations. Then, as they say in the business circles, he pivoted. In 1992, he made the visionary decision to convert the Rossi stores into what we now know as Dollarama. Il n'a pas tardé à franchir les frontières de la province natale de la famille Rossi pour ouvrir un premier magasin à l'extérieur du Québec, à Grand Falls, au Nouveau-Brunswick, puis un autre en Ontario, puis au Manitoba, en Alberta, en Saskatchewan, en Colombie-Britannique, sans oublier Terre-Neuve. En 2012, Dollarama a inauguré son 700e magasin au Canada et la chaîne en compte aujourd'hui 1030 et son chiffre d'affaires annuel dépasse les 2,5 milliards de dollars. That is one side of Larry Rossi. Then there is the Larry Rossi, the community leader, who along with his wife, Cookie, is a tireless champion for healthcare. Par sa générosité exceptionnelle, Larry Rossi a eu une profonde influence sur la vie de milliers de Montréalais, de Québécois et de Canadiens. Not one to seek the limelight, his focus is always on the people in need. His commitment has taken many forms over the years, and we are fortunate that he has been a great supporter of McGill. For example, Larry is helping our university deliver mental health and wellness services that are customized to the needs of our students. And of course, there is the extensive Rossi Cancer Network, which works to improve the quality of life of the tens of thousands of Quebecers who are diagnosed with cancer each year, and of course, improve the lives of their family. Quelle que soit l'envergure des projets qu'il a appuyés, Larry Rossi a toujours œuvré inlassablement pour améliorer de façon significative la vie des Québécois. En 2014, il a été nommé officier de l'Ordre national du Québec. The following year, he was appointed to the Order of Canada in recognition of his contributions to the retail sector in Canada and for his support of healthcare and social service organizations. It is with great pleasure that I now call upon our Chancellor to confer upon Mr. Lawrence G. Rossi, McGill's University highest honor, the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite Dr. Larry Rossi to deliver the convocation address. Dr. Rossi.
Okay. Chancellor Meehan, Chairman of the Board, Kip Cobbett, Principal Fortier, honored guests, distinguished faculty members, proud families, friends, and fellow McGill grads. When Principal Fortier asked me to give today's address, I was honored and moved. Initially, then I was more than a little apprehensive. What could I say that would be of value to you at this point in your life? How could I inspire you? and your futures. The things I like to talk about are mostly related to retail. As my family knows, I really perk up when the conversation turns to things like real estate sites for a new store or interesting items I found in my last buying trip, none of which make YouTube-worthy commencement speeches. In preparing for today, I had to recall my years at McGill all the way back to 1965, and as I thought about it, I remembered friends, new and old, special professors, and their classes, and mostly the sheer exuberance of youth. Suddenly, I realized that, just like most of you, I had no clear direction coming out of McGill. That's when it clicked. Maybe there is something I could share with you. Simply put, graduating isn't the end of anything. It's actually the beginning of everything. Whether that means pursuing your education further or starting your career, now is the time to jump in head first. So allow me to share my 7 life lessons that may guide you from here. First and foremost, do what you love and do it with passion. If you do what you love, you'll never work a day in your life. I'm a living example of that, and don't think my life was a straight line, because it wasn't and rarely is for anyone. I began working in my family's general variety stores as a summer job during my McGill days, and then full-time after I graduated. And it wasn't written on the wall that one day I would lead that business, nor was it set in stone that I would be successful in retail. And no one could have predicted when we opened our first Dollarama location in 1992 that we'd become a national retail chain with over 1,000 stores. I began Dollarama when I was 50, and today at 73, I'm still very passionate about what I do. And this leads to the next important lesson I want to share with you. It's not about being the first at something, it's about being the best at it. I can assure you I did not invent the dollar store concept. Before I opened that first store, the concept was widely present in the US for a number of years, and there were already a few shops here and there in Montreal. So you do not need to have an original idea, but you need to execute it better than anyone else. I have witnessed many businesses fail by trying to copy the perceived success of others. You must chart your own course and pursue life in your own way. When we started Dollarama, the dollar stores of that era were mostly dimly lit, messy shops that were not destined for lasting success. As a result, we rethought everything, changed the product, the packaging, the entire store environment. We focused on providing our customers with the best value. In essence, we charted our own course and executed our own vision of the dollar store. When we opened our first store, we did it carefully, conservatively, and strategically. Here comes the next lesson. Do not fear failure. You will never succeed if you never take any risks. When I was running the Rossi chain before the switch to Dollarama, I saw our retail landscape shifting and the competitive environment getting tougher. I saw an opportunity to roll out this new retail model, but it was at a huge risk. It takes hard emotional work to learn from what isn't working and to try again differently and better the second or third time around. Truth be told, I doubt very much I would be standing here before you today if I hadn't made that crucial decision to try something new and open the first Dollarama store. Ready for more? It's also very important to always challenge yourself. Do not let yourself get bored or complacent. Try new things and, in fact, always build. You may not know where it's going, but it's always worth the journey to try something new and see how things play out. When I started working in the family business, I wasn't fully challenged, so I tried a number of other ventures, including footwear, household textiles, and exercise fitness. Looking back, I now realize how much I learned from my various life experiences. Like my time at McGill, each and every thing I have done has become a part of me, and each and every experience has prepared me in some way for the journey that has been my life. I have tried and failed more than once, but I always got up and tried again and again until I found my true passion. Next lesson, timing. Try to be aware of the windows of opportunity that open for moments in time and then may close forever. Try to develop a skill of keeping your eyes open for opportunities as they arise, and whatever métier you choose, the right timing will be a key element of your success. As McGill grads, I'm sure you're all very bright, but brains alone will not make you successful. Success requires your intelligence be coupled with timing, hard work, and dedication to your particular field. So if you've been counting, this is life lesson number 6. Take every opportunity you can to learn from others. I've learned from all the people whose paths I have crossed throughout my life. I believe wholeheartedly that you win by being a good listener. And lastly, while you attain a modicum of success, giving back matters. The most important thing that success has brought is the ability to give back. It wasn't obvious to me when I started out, but I can assure you that as your ability to give grows, so will your generosity, or at least so it should. Creating our Rossi Cancer Network and Family Foundation has fulfilled our lives immeasurably. Believe it, it is better to give than to receive. So, should you choose to follow this advice and use your God-given smarts, plus all you have learned here at McGill, then there's a chance that one day you too will be invited to give the convocation speech. It has been said that the secret of success is a good spouse and a happy family life. I've been blessed on both counts. In this spirit, I'm delighted to share this honor with my wife, Cookie, and my family here with me today. We are humbled by this honor. So please allow me to close with a shout out to Montreal. I've been fortunate enough to travel the globe. In my humble opinion, Montreal is an incredible city in a great promise and one of the best countries in the world. I hope that your time at McGill has turned at least some of you into Montrealers. We welcome you with open arms. To the class of 2016, remember this great day and remember this great achievement. Remember above all that life is a gift, and the way you live your life is your gift to those who come after you. Make it a fantastic life by seizing each moment and always challenge yourself to do better and to be better than you were the day before. Thank you and congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Rossi, for those excellent words of wisdom, which I'm sure will not be soon forgotten. Nous allons maintenant procéder à l'attribution des grades académiques. And I call upon Provost and Vice Principal Academic Christopher Manfredi to commence the formal proceedings. Professor Manfredi.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. I am pleased to invite the students graduating from the Desautels Faculty of Management for the conferral of degrees. This is a truly joyous event in the cycle of a university's life, particularly at McGill, where we have such talented and accomplished students. Each student crossing the stage this afternoon will be greeted by the Chancellor, the Principal, or the Chair of the Board of Governors. Students receiving their first degree shall remove their mortarboard or hat. At center stage, they will be symbolically capped, probably without injury, signaling ceremonially the conferral of the degree. Students who have already earned a university degree keep their mortarboard on and will be congratulated by a tap on the shoulder. The parchment or degree itself is given to students by the dean or delegate after they leave the stage and have a photo taken. You may have seen some students wearing red or white scarves. All self-identifying Indigenous students, First Nations, Inuit, and Métis, are entitled to wear graduation scarves at convocation, in the community, and at any and all future McGill events they attend. The red scarf is for those receiving a degree, and white for those getting a diploma or certificate. The feather has two meanings: respect for the person, and it marks an amazing or special event. The Confederacy belt signifies attachment to and respect for the land on which we live. And the turtle symbolizes the inclusiveness of all nations and respect for diversity. En vertu des pouvoirs qui me sont conférés par le Sénat de McGill, je déclare que les candidats dont le nom figure sur la liste officielle des diplômés de l'université, qu'ils soient présents ou absents, ont satisfait aux exigences de leur grade, diplôme ou certificat respectif.
By virtues of the powers conferred upon me by McGill Senate,
I declare that the candidates whose names appear on the university's official list of graduates, whether they be present or absent, have satisfied the requirements for the respective degrees, diplomas, or certificates. By tradition at McGill, we begin with students receiving graduate degrees, followed by students obtaining undergraduate degrees. I now invite Professor David Ragsdale to introduce the graduates, and Professor Isabelle Bajeux, Dean of the Deshotels Faculty of Management, to congratulate all graduating students. Congratulations, class of 2016. Félicitations.
For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Management, Amir Akbari. Sumitra Aushatrako. Feng Jiao. Yasser Rorovani. For the degree of Master of Business Administration in Joint EMBA McGill HEC Montreal, Mike Allen. Giuseppe Argento. Antoine Atara. Marc-André Beaulieu. Edouard Biot. Laurent David Blanchard. Martin Carrier. Rodrigo Alberto Carvajal. Stephen Chamberlain. Hugo Delorme. Nicholas Fortin. Remy Fournier. Paul Ferfaro. Daniel Genier. Marie-Pierre Germain. Jean-Marc Gilbert. Delaine Guay. Helmut Erwin Harold. Manon Genot. Alexander Rodriguez Zhang. Guillaume Lavoie. Julie Levesque. Solange Thai Mai Xuan. Jean-Francois Marcotte Paget. Carolyn Morin. Roger Ketcha Nassam. Nadine Pruel. Pierre Rajot. Marcus Ruby. Luis Richet. Chantal Robitaille. Olivier Rossman. Steve Rousseau. Sandra Swenor. Jean-Claude Chipama. Guy Viau. Galen Zhang. For the degree of Master of Business Administration in Management, Shashank Ari. Saad Ahmad. Nader Akawi. Afra Hadef Al-Dahari. Vanessa Denise Allen. Catherine Argiriou. Ricardo Asmat Calderon, Medal for Great Distinction in the Professional Part-Time MBA Program. Silvia Pilar Barboza Garcia. Nikhil Baveja. Oscar Basera Sabagal. Carmel Ben-Or. Jacob Biernacki, Dean's Medal for Great Distinction in the MBA program. Dean's Medal for Great Distinction in the MBA program. Twice. Simon Booth. Patrick Braley. Olivier Rousseau. Sahil Vijay Butala. Maria Jimena Camancha Suarez. Marco Cavalluzzi. Monica Shahari. Ying Chen. Alexandra Harper Sergensky. Nicholas Connolly. Tatiana Crisan. Massimo D'Argenio. Edward Martin Thomas Dashwood. Julien Denoyer Chade. Nicholas Drohojowski. Nabil El Asrawi. Yahia Ashraf El Kouli. Fang Fang. Serge Farah. Fatou Diakar Fateh. Rohan Raghunath Fegde. Fernando Lopez Fertini. Amanda Giotti. Santiago Garzon Forero. Radhika Gupta. George Nadam Haddad. Joe Haddad. Christopher William Hearn. Rogelio Hernandez. Alvar Manuel Herrera. Amirali Kavusian. Tasneem Keshavji. Kiran Khan. James Koski. Bengisu Kusku. Mathieu Levesque Lavallee. Svetlana Malcheva. Simone Marcotte Lejarre. Barbaros Serdar Azoy. Melissa Zoe Papaniotto. Frederick Parisian. Jorge Enrique Pedraza Arias. Pooja Pillai. Victor Mauricio Prada Suarez. Oliver Drew Proudlock. Arjun Puntham Becker Hemchander. Anam Raja. Muhammad Yasir Raja. Musab Sabri. Tarek Sadani. Nan Just Sluis. Thomas Lay. Philippe Marcotte, Dean's Medal for Great Distinction in the MBA program. Guillaume Simard. Harmit Singh. Brian Albert St. James. Jorge Tato Sanchez Medal. Amisha Arvind Tibrewala. Lorenzo Torre. Quoc Hai Christoph Truong. Natalia Valencia Lesmes. James Michael Wheel. Christopher William Wolski. Kajan Singh Yadav. Yi Zhang. For the degree of Master of Business Administration in MBA, Japan, Daniel Edward Bednar. Francois Bergeron. Mark Blomquist. Shinji Hayashi. Daisuke Kikuchi. Giselle Mendez Grant. Youngmi Park. Kaori Tachibana. Hoi Yi Joey Wu. Ye Yang. Kyle Yi. For the degree of Master of Management in International Masters for Practicing Managers, Abdul Mohsen Adel Babsail. Wilson Junior Lapointe. For the degree of Master of Management in Manufacturing Management, China, Kewi Bu. Jin Fu. Shun Li. Dan Shi. Peng Zhou. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Accounting, Gabrielle Elare, Distinction. Marissa Noreen Barkhouse. Cassandra Berrio. Kaitan Bata, Distinction. Daniel Besner. Megan Tyler Binder, Distinction. Leah Paul Trudel Baudrier. Jenny Bradley Tessier. Commerce 1925 Award Dean's Honor List. Faizan Yawar Butt. Chui Yi Chao, Distinction. Laurent Dano Pelican, Distinction. Richard Michael Despati, Commerce 1925 Award, McGill Accounting Society Prize, Dean's Honor List. Cassandra Elizabeth Douglas. Simone Dubot Mimo. Sarah Kristen Elwood, Dean's Honor List. Olivier Garceau. Crystal Gauthier, Distinction. Guillaume Girard. Kai Hua He, Herbert E. Siblin Award, Dean's Honor List. Tiffany Sia. Xiao Fei Ji. Jasreet Kaur. Tulsi Das Kulani. Leonid Kim. Nathaniel Anson Kirsch, Commerce 1925 Award, Dean's Honor List. Kayla Elizabeth Kucharavi. Navita Kumar. Katie Melinda Susan LaChapelle, Dean's Honor List. Angel Lang. Elizabeth Lefebvre. Jianyan Li. Shuiying Li. Sean Patrick Lim Kian Siang. Dana Lin. Zhao Lin. Jacqueline Liu. Sai Liu. Yu Xian Liu. Sarah Luchan. Min Lu. Richard Lupovich. Georgia Alexandra Markakis, Distinction. Sayed Usman Masood. James David McCullough Gilbert, Peter S. Wise Memorial Prize, Dean's Honor List. Alexander Francis McGarry, Commerce 1925 Award, Dean's Honor List. Matthew Minook, Distinction. Jake Andre Mueller. Vincent Nguyen. Makanaka Nguyenya, Distinction. Alana Nussbaum, Commerce 1925 Award, Dean's Honor List. Allison Orenstein. David Orloff, Distinction. Prerna Ramaswamy. Sarah Iqbal Remu. Ren Shen. Cedric Demers. Kayla Afton Rendick, Dean's Honor List. Stephanie Saba. Joel Ilana Salzman, Dean's Honor List. Fiorella Schifino, Distinction. Matthew Brandon Shriver. Adam Brandon Shapiro. Adam Mitchell Shibuya. Kansu Aslu. Hannah Nicole Voigt, Distinction. Lauren Wehner. Kaylun Wang. Xin Wen, Distinction. Stephanie Sarah Winitsky. Li Shu. Meng Chi Shu. Laura Yajing Zhang. Xue Zhang. Xinning Zheng. Jia Yi Zhou. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Economics, Jean-Francois Laurent Casanova, Dean's Honor List. Mustafa Oguz Kailan, Honors in Economics. Monica Nyambura Gachara. Roshan George. Francis Guiton. Sally Hahn. Alan Meng Liu. Marie Luca, First Class Honors in Economics, Dean's Honor List. Elif Morrow, Distinction. Joshua Pinto. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Economics and Accounting, Zayed Zain Ul Hassan, First Class Honors in Economics and Accounting. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Economics and Finance, Pak Hang James Chan, First Class Honors in Economics and Finance, Sir Edward Beattie Medal, Dean's Honor List. Chen Fan, Finestone Economics Prize, First Class Honors in Economics and Finance, Dean's Honor List. Sabrina Nicole Hill, First Class Honors in Economics and Finance. Michelle Lipsitz, First Class Honors in Economics and Finance. Johan Saba, Honors in Economics and Finance. Yuteng Zhang, Honors in Economics and Finance. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Finance, Uzair Ali. Tarek Alwan. Henri William Ash Tyler. Catherine Veronique Odette. Vincent Bernard, Dean's Honor List. Poya Bemaram, Distinction. Marwa Benzakur. Ravinder Singh Bueller. Nicholas Bokos, Dean's Honor List. Kasha Erica Bonville Pius. Jean-Félix Bouchard-Bellevance. Lucy Boyko. Florence Canton. Rui Xiao. Yasin Chabi. Yu Chen, Dean's Honor List. Xiao Ying Chen, Dean's Honor List. Maud Chich, L.J. Forget and Company Award, Dean's Honor List. Emilija Davidovich, Dean's Honor List. Gabrielle Davidson. Maud DeWitt. Arundhati Desai. Vikashan Singh Durga, Dean's Honor List. Peter Dranye, Distinction. Haitham Drine, Dean's Honor List. Yasmin Renee Dumouchel, Distinction. Alexander Daniel Factor, Distinction. Yuan Fang. Louis James Fark. Matteo Salvatore Fasanella. Dania Fayaz. Yuan Feng. Juan Sebastian Fernandez Flores. Eric Friedman, Distinction. Francois Philippe Gagnon. Yannick Galinas. Beatrice Gervais. Ines Gesmes. Yonat Constantin Germain. Manuel Gobay LeBlanc, Distinction. Furui Gao. Haya Hafar. Jessica Nicole Hahn. Heather Karen Hartley. Rafiq Hirani, Distinction. Nicholas Lazarian Ho. Nicole Imamagian, Distinction. Shui Jiang, Dean's Honor List. Carolyn Jodouin Lapierre. Daniel Xing-Un Kang. Alan Andre Kasparian. Ryan Curry. Frederic Rudolph Lavillet, Distinction. Yasmin Lazrak. Stephen Lee. Marie Lemoine, Distinction. Liu Yang Li. Stanley Lee. Tao Liu. William Martin, Distinction. Jean-Philippe Mathieu, Dean's Honor List. Shamir Ali Mirza. Himani Nagrath. Miriam Naguib. Tony Coy Lee Nguyen. Hamza Obeid. Maxime Ort Dubuc. Philippe Marsolet. Stephanie Joanne Ott. Melissa Pasquarelli. Philippe Pastry, Distinction. Jean-Philippe Perrault McNulty. Evgenia Osaskova, Distinction. Jeremy Picard, Distinction. Punhal Pirzada. Benjamin Pisarevsky. Olivier Poul, Distinction. Dario Ramatian. Alexis Randolph. Etienne Ricard, Distinction, or Dean's Honor List, sorry. Mitchell James Richardson, Distinction. Adam Sakri. Joshua Samuel Shulman. Nicholas Mark Schwab. Alexander Sapassi. J. Ashish Seth. Stephanie Setiawan, Dean's Honor List. Yu Qi Shao. Munveer Arjun Singh Sidhu. Antoine Simon. Baraj Singh. Mackenzie Speak. Audrey St. John. Beatrice St. John, Distinction. Siobhan Stendel, Dean's Honor List. Ryan Stetiu Otis. Fahad Mohammed Sayed. Tariq bin Zayed Sayed. Jonathan Ryan Tan Yan, Dean's Honor List. Mehdi Tazi, Distinction. Denizan Uyker, Dean's Honor List. Aonan Wong. Matthew Wong. Wen Ching Shu, Distinction. Yinghui Shu, Distinction. Simon Yaramian. Xuefei Yin, Distinction. Mai Yuan Zhang. Jing Zhou. Shiru Zhu. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in General Management, Enya Absi. Daniel Alman Paramo. Payal Anish Javarchand. Julie Bachelot. Matthew Barbares. Jacqueline Baudinet. Charles Baudry, Distinction. Othmain Belazin. Arthur Gaston Serge Belanger, Distinction. Lucille Bertin. Anders Timon Jella. Inez Cecilia Blondet. Murat Buldanlioglu. Ilyana Chertkova. Maria Christina Sismaru, Dean's Honor List. Michelle Esther Cooper. Cedric Coulomb. It's okay. Salim Daif, Distinction. Hubert Daglio. Thomas Bryce Marie De Pomero. Paul Carey Damascus. Sarah Nicole Devine. Li Xuan Uyen Matilda Doe. Alec Robert Draymore. Elodie Dulisque. You got that. Emmerich Marie Durand de Boussingen. Amanda Carly Ettingen. Louis-Philippe Ferland. Adam Francois Fisher. Martin Fontaine. Jamila Forrest. Emma Heather Martine Francois. Elisa Gauthier. Fanny Monique Girard. Arya Gamalin, Dean's Convocation Prize, Dean's Honor List. Maxime Graton. Jared Tyler Green. Alexander Nicholas Gaillard. Ahmed Habab. Sufana Hamza, Dean's Honor List. Callie Harvey. Anthony Heinrich. Amanda Stephanie Hindley. Caitlin Ella Marie Jean Grand. Joelle Catan. Zainab Naz K. Kaselyaglu. Byomsik Kim. Brody Hannah Kirsch. Noah Lackstein, Distinction. Lily LaFrance Jones. Cassidy Levine, Distinction. Yan Ran Lu. Francesca Elizabeth McKinnon. Justin Alexander Magnan. Raluca Iona Mantu. Pierre Maruzzi. Yami. Louis Manviel. Salome Michelle Mirigay. Maxime Samuel Nia Rouquette. Arifa Akhtar Nital. Alexander Norman, Distinction. Adam Nowakzinski, Distinction. Liu Dan Pam. Jessica Rose Panetta. Jules Henri Perrault. Monique Pataki. Marie Rougier. Abhishek Girija Sahu. Aya Schechner, Dean's Honor List. Chrisendra Chakri. Elena Etty Siso. Nathan Skelton. Yigitkan Yildiz. Faisal Alam Suki. Mark Stephen Stephen. Karen Darien. Eleanor Tsang. Misawa Holmes Prize in International Business, Dean's Honor List. Jade Marie Eve Van Carr. Galina Jujovic, Dean's Honor List. Wei Wong. Jonathan David Wright. Shuhao Zhou. Emily Jai Zhou. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Information Systems, Lean Al-Barkawi. Aline Camille Bertrand. McKenna Lee Cochran. Inez Regina Clarisse Dumont. Matthew Freimel. Jennifer Pang Glover. Alexa Lovicelli Gretsch. Andrea Mann. Kaylee Aisha Miner. Mikhail Pogosian. Rehab Rebai, Distinction Hugh Howson Memorial Prize. Yuri Vincent Sambal, Distinction. Laura Sibel Sisa. Elisa Stock. Nicholas Alexander Zerbikage. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in International Management, Farida Abdelghani. Dena Hossam Anwar. Muriel Bisner. Alexandra Asa Boudreaux Manos. Lysis Audrey Maurice Berger Venin. Julie Ann Brault. Hugo Bu Hoi. Fabienne Cezanne. Marc-André Charpentier. Thomas Colin Lefebvre. Laura Dowd, Distinction. Vladimir De Ziegler. Marianne Omeya El Yordi Morera. Elizabeth Gladkov. Ali Ihab Gohar. Abigail Rose Hunter, Distinction. Tala Iskandarani, Distinction. Marine Perwez Khan. William Lowe. Saul Ernest Muskin. Lauren Rezon. Aya Munir Saket. Shazia Nizmuddin Sharif. Cameron Cole Smith. Aud St. Cyr, Distinction. Michelle Yu. Ethan Michael Zmenek. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Investment Management, Naomi Gendron, First Class Honors in Investment Management, McGill Alumni Society Prize, Dean's Honor List. Philippe Rich, First Class Honors in Investment Management, Dean's Honor List. Daniel Sorek, First Class Honors in Investment Management, Stephen S. Goldblum Memorial Prize, Dean's Honor List. Henri Francois St. Pierre, First Class Honors in Investment Management, L.J. Forget and Company Award, Dean's Honor List. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Labor Management Relations and Human Resources, Casey Michelle Bryant, Laddie Millen Memorial Prize. Ashley Vanessa Schul, Laddie Millen Memorial Prize. Meilin Ju. Qibing Zhu. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Management for Sustainability, Maxime Andre Chul. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Marketing, Joseph Ackle. Liam Amil Hastra. Daniel He Chan An. Alexandra Bon Saint. Joni Brochu. Delaney Victoria Brown Distinction. Sophie Chapdelaine. Laurence DeCary Duprat. Marie Sophie Demare. Elliot Todd Fabrice Demelier. Elizabeth Catherine Emerson. Muhammad Yahya Essa. Catherine Alexa Felton. Thank you. Maripaz Fernandez. Louis Felix Provencher, Distinction. Gabrielle Emily Gendron. Laura Pauline Gordon, Distinction. Natalie Hill. Kelsey Hopps. Nicholas Joseph Hunsley. Nabil Nazir Kadabuks. Justin Terrence Kieran. Megan Kwan. Lindsay Landsman. Kaylee Olivia Lankinen. Brian Lau, Dr. M. Richard Gelfand Prize in Marketing, Dean's Honor List. Fung Sim Leung. Peter Macario, Distinction. Khan Morrow. Anne Sophie Martin, Dean's Honor List. Blandine Natalie Marie Jean Mogé. Genevieve Kirsten McCollum, Distinction. Leah Sarah Mendelson. Daniel Metlitsky. Nidhi Mishra. Livia Marie Nikolai. Alexander Painshow. Lydia Park. Kathleen Ann Pynchon. Remy Pinto. Capucine Razou. Revel de Bretteville. Marie Eugenie Ribieras. Sophie Rutenberg. Guillaume Séjourné. Braden Skerritt. Na Jung Song. Shireen Tiagi. Samuel James Viss. Melissa White. Robert Joel Wilson. Sijia Yi. Haviva Yezgat. Xin Zhao. Kaylee Zrihan, Distinction. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Psychology, Kirsten Pinch. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce in Strategic Management, Cassandra Delage. Ariane Durand. Colleen Fiave. Nathan Gere. Elizabeth Sarah Novak, Distinction. Taryn Ouellette, Distinction. Diana Peng. Noah Nathaniel Seltzer. Hannah Elizabeth Wilkinson. Kim Zupanski.
Now my pleasure to invite Mr. Philippe Rich to deliver a few words as this year's valedictorian. Mr. Rich.
Bon après-midi à tous. Good afternoon, Mr. Chancellor, members of the Platform Party, distinguished guests, Dr. Rossi, and of course, fellow graduates. It is with great humility and honor that I stand here to address the last words today for the commencement of one of the finest universities in the world, but chiefly for the commencement of the Dizzletel graduating class of 2016, truly a group of the most passionate and spirited people I have ever met. Five hundred sixty-eight days of hope. Hope that we would make it to this day. Don't get me wrong, every single day was memorable in its own way and allowed us to truly understand what McGill's motto that you can see on the coat of arms on this podium and across this room actually means. Grandiscut auctus labore, by work all things increase and grow. And boy, did we work, and boy, did we grow. We went through bright wins and tough losses, cold tears and genuine laughs, new friendships and unforgettable love stories, devoted administrators and inspiring professors. But today marks the end of our 568-day journey at McGill. I'm convinced that we will all be talking a lot about these glorious years at this hotel, so I thought I could give you a few more numbers to follow up with Ms. Suzanne Fortier to spice up your conversations. So let's look back at our journey. 568 days of semester, but also 36 professors, 1,400 hours of classes, 84 exams, 10,000 hours of studies, 850 coffees, and 7 great all-nighters. And our great principal, Suzanne Fortier, mentioned how the McGill community gobbled down 40,000 bagels. But let's not forget the 15,000 delicious extra-large quesada burritos that we ate. And most important number of them all, 84 legendary Thursday afternoon, 4 to 7. I'm sure you agree with me that all of these numbers are impressive, but also that our experience at McGill transcends these statistics. We entered McGill as young virgin books, ready to be filled. And McGill and his professors filled our pages with priceless knowledge. But also much more than that. McGill taught us the ability to learn and be curious, to form an opinion and defend an argument, to analyze, question, be communicative and creative. It's also important to recognize that some of the best chapters and the finest stories in our books do not come from readings or textbooks, lectures or tutorials, nor do they include our transcripts, diploma or resumes. How did we make it here? What has McGill been to us? Well, turn your heads, look around, and you'll get the answer. Most of this was possible because our first, our beloved parents, and then our peers, our fellow colleagues. The friends we sit with today have become additions to our family and are undoubtedly some of the main characters in our book of life. We grew up together in Bronfen and at times on the grass of Lower Fields, when there is grass, and the confines of Mechelen Library. Our peers were our guidance, inspiration, and strength. And class, I know that you're strong. After all, together in the past years, we survived a major flood on McTavish, Ebola, the accounting midterm, and the heartbreaking loss of our beloved Sinfully Asian. Now, sitting here today, our digital tell journey has come full circle. Once prospective students, we're now alumni. Many of us still don't know what we want to do. What is our purpose in life? Personally, I'm officially starting my finance job in a few weeks, but I'm also strongly considering buying a one-way ticket to Bali, where I want to start a surf and yoga school. Please don't tell my mom. No matter what path I choose, what path you choose, we have to trust the wealth of knowledge that McGill has brought us. No matter in what we believe, God, Buddha, life, burritos, whatever, we have to trust and believe in ourselves and in the things we've learned here. This will give us the confidence to follow our hearts even when it leads us off the well-worn path. And let's remember that success is not a destination, but a continuous journey. Je suis certain que ceci n'est pas la fin des relations entre nous tous et avec McGill, mais plutôt le commencement d'une nouvelle étape. Un attachement qui va durer et qui va nous réunir à travers les industries et les continents, qui va nous permettre de nous surpasser dans nos carrières. Class, the fact that you're graduating from McGill University today is a testament to your perseverance and commitment to excellence. Each and every one of you has grown into powerful, intellectual individuals destined to greatness. And with the potential to change the world. Really, that's not just some empowering commencement speech fluff. There's a great quote from Steve Jobs that is particularly relevant here and today. Quote, "When you grow up, you tend to get told that the world is the way it is, and your life is just to live your life inside the world. But life can be much broader once you discover one simple fact. Everything around you that you call life was made up by people that were no smarter than you. And you can change it, you can influence it, you can build your own things that other people can use." I'd like to finish off by giving a challenge to all of you and myself, something I think we learned here at McGill. No matter what's the story in your next chapter, try to wake up every day and remember that we're not human doings, but human beings. It's not about what we do, what's on our resume, our transcript, what we show off to our friends. It's about how we do it, with who we do it, and why we do it. To the class of 2016, strive to be the best version of yourself, and thank you all for these amazing last 4 years. Congratulations, félicitations, merci.
Thank you, Philippe. Would the graduating class please rise? In my capacity as Chancellor of McGill, I declare and confirm that each of you is now entitled to the distinction of the degree, diploma, or certificate that has been conferred upon you with all the honors, rights, and responsibility that are pertinent thereto. Congratulations to you all. Félicitations. Would the audience please rise? Et je demande maintenant au secrétaire général, M. Stephen Stropel, de prononcer la bénédiction. Mr. Stropel.
Go now in peace and share the gift of knowledge that has been entrusted to you. May this university and all graduates be diligent in the free and honest pursuit of truth for the benefit of all. Du que nous venions, que nous allions, humble et plein d'espoir, nous nous laisserons guider par l'amitié et la solidarité, et nous grandirons en sagesse. May you be blessed all your days.
And to conclude the ceremony this morning, Professor Winston Purdy will lead us in the singing of our national anthem. Professor Purdy.